could win a piano, a home video center, a gold bracelet, or a trip to New York, and continue a journey towards a fortune in cash and prizes, including this Datsun 300ZX and $50,000 in cash. In total, over $100,000 on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Perry.
Why, thank you. Oh, what a nice group. Thank you so much. The waiting contestants, nice to see you there. And welcome to Sale of the Century. Let us welcome back our champion, Jeff Hewitt. Hello, Jeff.
Hi.
Continuing to do very well. A couple of lovely trips. What, Hawaii you're going off to? You said you'd never been there, right?
Never been there and always wanted to go.
Well, that should be nice. And some lovely money as well. Well over three. I think you're somewhere in the neighborhood of $5,000-$6,000 in cash. Over $17,000 in total and still going strong. Good luck today.
Thank you very much.
Here to introduce the challengers, Lee Manning.
Hi, Lee.
Hello.
You just came back. So you haven't seen that winner's board before, right?
I just came back, and what a great new thing.
Isn't that nice?
It's super. Everybody goes home with something all the time, and it's still exciting because you have to pick the number. I like it.
That's good.
I'm glad.
Who do you have for us?
Our first contestant knows how to jazz up a conversation. Originally from Little Rock, Arkansas, let's welcome Jazz Greenwood.
Hello, Jazz.
And our next contestant is a journalist. Originally from Kansas City, Missouri, let's welcome Tom Gower.
Hello, Tom.
Hi, Tom.
See you later with some bargains, Lee. Tom, you're making yourself comfortable out there, just hanging on and hugging as you're coming out.
It's nice.
A journalist, you must have had some unusual experiences.
Oh, a couple. Probably the most, dangerous story was actually a feature story with a couple of circus clowns. I was volunteered by some people, and they threw flaming torches over my head.
Oh, my goodness, that does sound exciting.
They said they rarely miss. Rarely.
Rarely. Nice to have you here, Tom. And you know how to jazz up a conversation, Jazz.
Oh, I certainly do. I love to talk. It's a great hobby of mine. And 1 month, I talked the phone, fell right through the ceiling.
Yeah? A biggie, huh?
A biggie.
Well, you get a chance. If you hit that buzzer first, you get a chance to talk a lot here.
Okay.
So good luck to all three of you as we start you off with $20 and with this question. What game are you playing if someone calls out B19, Jazz?
Bingo.
Bingo. You got yourself $5 of the 25. George wrote the music while Brother Ira penned the lyrics. Jeff.
Gershwin.
Gershwin is exactly right. It took a moment, but Jeff is right. Beat that buzzer. He goes to 25. According to the adage, what is it you can't teach an old dog? Jeff.
New trick.
Jeff is very quick with that buzzer. Tom just beats you to the buzzer. Jeff goes into the lead. What kind of chewy candy are you making, Jazz?
Taffy.
If you are at a poll, you are right. That's taffy. Nicely anticipated. Time now for Distant Bargain. Player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise. Sale surprise. Well, the bonus could come up at any time. We've got a tie. Jazz and Jeff now. Only one of you can have this. So when you hear the low sale of the century price, hit your buzzer and would you... excuse me. This is yours.
Oh, how mushy. Hitachi's cassette match music system, AM/FM stereo receiver with 7.5 watts per channel, belt drive turntable with magnetic cartridge, two-way hydrone cone speaker system, all furnished by Hitachi. And this great music system is normally priced at $419. Break it up, guys. But you can buy it today for just $6 on Sale of the Century.
Jazz is going to buy. Daddy. We're done now. It's over. Never mind. Okay. That's great. Lovely Hitachi stereo system. It is yours for just $6, Jazz. Enjoy that. We knocked the $6 off your score. You're at a 24, but you've got yourself a great stereo. Figuratively speaking, what part of his body did an unfortunate rabbit lose in order, Jeff?
Tail.
No, you don't have your rabbit tails up there on the top of your television. For you get a clear television reception. That's rabbit ears. That's the figuratively speaking, we said, rabbit ears. And the champion loses five. He still has a $1 lead. This former Milwaukee school teacher went on to become Prime Minister of Israel. Jazz.
Sadat.
No, not Sadat, no. Sadat wasn't Prime Minister of Israel last time. No, Golda Meir. Golda Meir, just down the road a piece from Sadat. So you lose $5 on that, Jeff. Sorry about that. Fame game now. We play not for dollars, but for a pick of that fame game board. We're looking for a famous thing. Keep that in mind, a famous thing. I was invented in 1979. My creators sold stock in me that will make millionaires of people who... Jeff?
Trivial Pursuit.
Yes, indeed. Now, everybody who had a piece of that made a lot of money. Jeff, you can make some money right now. Pick up the board.
Number six.
And behind number six, we have...
$10!
Mine's a $10 money card, and the champion has, instead of a $5 lead, he jumps up into a $15 lead as we add the $10 to his score, and we'll be right back after this commercial timeout. Back to business. Just a brief reminder, our home viewer contest, that sale of the century dollar bill contest continues. So have your $1 bills handy a little bit later. Who knows, you could make a lot of money. So be with us with the $1 bills a little bit later in the show. Right now, Jeff at 35, Tom at 20, Jazz at 19, but she's got a great stereo. We're back with this. Originally called a clasp locker, you can find this fascinating device. Jazz?
Clatch?
No, running up and down boots, pants, and skirts, and everything else. A zipper. A zipper is what that is. A clasp locker is what it was. Sorry about that, Jazz. You lose a five. A gardening tool, a smoked herring, or a man's shoe. What is this kipper? Tom.
A fish.
Smoked fish. What? Our judge, I got to check with the judge. Yeah. The judge will accept that. I don't think the gardening tool or the man's shoe fit in the category of the fish. The smoked herring, it had to be. You're right, Tom. You gave me even more information. You knew the smoked herring was a fish. Up to 25. On the Celsius scale, what is the boiling point of water? Jeff?
100.
100 it is. The champion heard from again. Up to 40. And Jeff, now you've got yourself a $15 lead with an instant bargain and the opportunity to buy this.
It's time to treat yourself to a matched pair of Lord and Lady Elgin dress wristwatches in a traditional square design with custom case and attached band in an attractive woven design furnished by Elgin. And these lovely watches are normally priced at $705, but can be yours today for just $11 on sale of the century.
Aren't they lovely? Now, Jeff, you said you got something finally for your father. Your mother didn't get something for
right.
Your father. If you didn't want these for yourself, there's one for Daddy, one for Mom, one for your father, one for your mother. $11. You would still have a $4 lead.
One. Think of your parents.
Two. Three. Four.
Oh, yeah.
$1,105. You'd have a $4 lead. You'd make your mother and father happy going once. Going twice. And no sale.
Dad loses again.
Dad is going to be mad. I thought you'd like a heck of a bargain there, Jeff, but that's your decision. You're hanging on to the $15 lead. Back with this. John Lennon's tribute to her songwriting abilities, Jeff.
Yoko Ono.
And Every Man Has a Woman, the new album. Yoko Ono is exactly who John Lennon's woman was. Nicely anticipated, Jeff at 45. What common device comes in the following varieties? Princess, Trimline, Tom.
A telephone.
Telephone it is. Tom up to 30. Same with $15 with Jeff. We might guess from his name that he's the grouchiest of the seven dwarfs. Tom.
Grumpy.
Grumpy it is, and Tom goes to 35. What island nation has the capital city of Manila? Jazz.
Venezuela.
No. Where's the dot? No, the Philippines. The Philippines. The geography is not your strong suit there, Jazz. Down to 9. The Philippines. Incidentally, in the Philippines, when Jaime Sin became a priest, he took a lot of ribbing because of his last name. Well, now it's even funnier. Father Sin is currently the Archbishop of Manila and is known to his flock as Cardinal Sin. We'll be right back. Gentlemen bouncing back and forth, but Jeff has a $10 lead over Tom, 45 to 35. Come on, Jazz, I know you'll make a comeback. There's a $15 money card up there. Get your back into it as we look for a famous person. I was born in Pennsylvania in 1937. I moved to Los Angeles, where I planned to become an English teacher. Instead, I joined the L.A. Police Department, where I gathered material from my books about cops. Tom.
Joseph Wambaugh.
That's exactly who it is. Joseph Wambaugh, yes. A lot of books. The Blue Angel, Blue Knight, The Onion Field, The Choir Boys, and a pick of the board for Tom.
Number 4.
And behind him before we have a microwave oven. The Lipton Go Anywhere microwave oven for the family room, dorm, or kitchen. It features electronic touch control, 2 memory levels, and clock. Furnished by Lipton Microwave Cooking.
Very nice. $349 worth. Yours to keep. What, Tom?
I finally get a microwave.
You got a microwave. Congratulations. That's it. Didn't find a money card, though. We're going to put that, leave the 15 up there and add 25 later. All three players now with this. To what great painter might you say, gee, I like your sunflowers, Vinny? Jeff?
Van Gogh.
Yeah, that's right. If you were a Roman, you might say, lend me your ear. You're right for another 5. Going to 50. What's the name of the fourth letter of the Greek alphabet? Jeff?
Omega.
Oh, it happens to be shaped like a triangle, as a matter of fact, Delta. And quick buzzer this time cost the champion five. What superstar played the leader of the motorcycle club in The Wild One?
Jeff. Fonda?
Oh, no, that goes back for Marlon Brando. Remember that? Oh, in one of his great films. And you lose another five. So, Jeff, that puts you in an interesting position. You haven't wanted to buy except when you had a big lead. You don't have a big lead now, but you do have the lead by $5 over Tom. You can buy this.
For Alfresco Adventures, this picnic hamper, handmade in wicker with service for four, filled with beautiful china and stemware, furnished by Celeste. And it's normally priced at $1,000, but can be yours today for just $15 on sale at the Century.
That is incredible. My goodness. That is unique, and it is very, very beautiful, I must say. Now, Jeff, it is $15. You're ahead by five. I'll give you a sporting chance at it. I will knock $5 off the score. You can have this, and it is gorgeous. $1,000 worth of hamper for $10, but you would be trailing by $5 if you bought it. Going once, going twice.
Just too close.
No sale. Hanging on to a $5 lead with Tom breathing down his neck. We'll be back for the finale after this. Looking for another crack at that winner's board, but he's hanging on to a slender $5 lead at this point. Back with this. In 1960, what two presidential candidates took part in the great Tom?
Kennedy and Nixon.
The great debate, Kennedy and Nixon it is, and Tom pulls abreast with Jeff, both at $40. Once the capital of the Confederacy, it's now the capital of Virginia. Tom.
Richmond.
Richmond it is, and the challenger Tom goes into the lead by five. Foul Play or Rear Window or The Big Sleep, which was directed by Alfred Hitchcock. Jeff.
Rear Window.
Rear Window was right, and Jeff pulls it on a tie with Tom again. Well, close game, fame game now. Big $25 money card up there as we look for a famous person. I was born in 1915 and started singing as a teenager. I entered a Major Bowes amateur contest and won first prize. Went on to sing with the big bands of jazz.
Frank Sinatra.
That's who it is, yes! Harry James and Tommy Dorsey, I was going to say. Now, Chess, you've only got $9 now, but there's $25 up there.
Number eight.
And behind number eight, we have a mantle clock. Michael C. Pena's 1810 Americana mantle clock with Westminster quarter-hour striking movement in a genuine walnut hand-rubbed case furnished by the Michael C. Pena Company.
Well, that's over $400 worth of clock, yours to keep. Where were the 15 and 25?
Yes, you were so close, the two, the five.
Right smack up the middle with the 25. We finish up the game now with the speed round. 60 seconds on the clock, please. And, Jazz, you're at $9, but I've got a lot of questions. But Tom and Jeff, we are in a tie. You both have $45. Good luck to all three players as we start the speed round. Now, name the great English writer who was nicknamed the Bard of Avon.
Jeff. Shakespeare.
Right. What green mineral causes Superman to lose his... Jeff.
Kryptonite.
Right. In the movie The French Connection, who portrayed Popeye? Jeff.
Hackman.
Right. Christopher Columbus discovered the New World as?
Plymouth Rock.
Time. In what country would you find the tomb of King Tut? Jeff.
Egypt.
Right. What pop superstar had hits Mandy and I Write the Song? Tom.
Barry Manilow.
Right. What kind of a creature is the swift-footed roadrunner? Jeff.
It's a bird.
Right. What mixer do you get when you combine quinine with water? Jazz.
Seltzer.
Wrong. What news organization is known by the initials AP? Jeff.
Associated Press.
Right. Name the handsome actor who plays the title role in Remington Steele. Jeff.
Pierce Brosnan.
Right. How many years are in a score? Jeff.
20.
Right. What is the former name of Vietnam's Ho Chi Minh City? Tom.
Saigon.
Right. With what form of popular entertainment do we associate? Time. Jeff, you've done it again. A moment, Jeff. Going beautifully. First of all, to wrap up, Christopher Columbus discovered the New World in 1492, and the mixer, quinine and water, you get tonic water. I have to say goodbye to a couple of fine players, I'm delighted to say. They are not going home empty-handed. Tom, you've got yourself the microwave worth $349, $55 in cash in front of you, so a profitable stay and our thanks.
Thank you.
And Jazz, she just got a couple of cracks at it, and she did very well with the stereo and the clock, $844 worth. Congratulations to
you,
Jazz.
A lot of fun.
And we'll go to the winner's news board with Jeff in just a moment, but right now, it is time for the Sale of the Century Dollar Bill Contest. So the home viewers, get your dollar bills out right now. If the first six numbers in the serial number are the same on your dollar bill, match in order the first six numbers of the final scores, you're a winner. Now that number is Tom at 55, Jazz went down to zero, so that will read out as 00, and Jeff at 85. So that number is 550085. If you have a winning dollar bill, sign your name in the margin of the bill and send it by registered mail only to Sale of the Century Contest, P.O. Box 4005, Blair, Nebraska, 68009. Include your name, complete address, and telephone number. We'll send back a dollar along with your share of the jackpot. Each winning bill may be redeemed only once, and according to the Treasury Department, there are 3,700,000,000 $1 bills in circulation, and that means that somewhere out there, there are 3,700 bills with today's winning serial number. I hope you have one. All winners over the 2 weeks of the contest will share the jackpot equally. The least you can win is $25. And if you're the only winner, you get the entire jackpot of $30,000. Dollar bills with today's winning serial number must be received no later than 10 days from the date of this broadcast. I'll give you the winning number again later in the program along with the complete rules. But right now for Jeff, come on, Jeff, let's get up there to the winner's board. Here we go again. It was interesting. Yes, you and Tom went back and forth, but it was interesting for the people who have zeros in their numbers. Suddenly, they got a couple of zeros to work with, and maybe it'll help somebody with the dollar bill contest. Jeff, as you know, up there on the board, some wonderful things. A trip to New York is there. There's a silver service. There's a $10,000 in cash up there someplace still. And you might be interested in this beautiful video center, Jay.
Bring the movies to life on this 45-inch rear projection color television. Gives you big screen TV viewing enjoyment in a one-piece cabinet, plus some of today's most advanced features in this convertible video cassette recorder. This prize is worth $5,050.
That's a very nice prize, Jeff, and it's up here on the board someplace. Of course, you've taken a lot of lovely things off this winner's board. We are down now to just 12 numbers. Somewhere up there is $10,000 in cash. There is that beautiful sporty car you've been looking at. As you know, you match up numbers. When you find two numbers that match, that prize is yours. There are two win cards up there. If you turn over a win card, the very next thing that you turn over, that is yours automatically. There is a card up there for the car, another for the $10,000 in cash. Good luck as you start picking numbers, Jeff.
I think it's time for the car. Let's go with number 11.
Number 11. He's had good instincts before. Video center. That's a beautiful prize.
14.
Number 14 has the video center. Third day in a row, you just turned over two numbers and got yourself a great prize. My good, congratulations. It's like you say to yourself, this is what I really want or something. Let's go over and take a good look at it over here. We saw it before. The video center is yours. It's beautiful. Over $5,000 worth of video equipment. It is yours. And Jeff, you never looked better in your entire life as on that video screen. We will be back to wrap up. We'll give you the home viewer dollar bill number and see where Jeff stands right after this commercial timeout. Congratulations to a fine champion, Jeff Hewitt. The last few days, it has been the Jeff Hewitt Show, and your new video center reflects that. There you are, Jeff Hewitt Show, all by it. Great prize. That's lovely. It adds to your winnings. And I must say, looking at the board over there now, we are down now to just 12 numbers left up there. So if you get up here as the winner on our next show, the odds become very much in your favor that you could have a shot, that $10,000 is there. That car, you've been eyeing this car. It could be yours just like that tomorrow with the right combination. And it's not too far-fetched to say that you have the ability to clear that board, plus this.
A cash bonus of $50,000.
And that in total is over $100,000 in cash and prizes, and you can stay on until you do that. That's what you can do. Now again, that winning number, remember, 550085. 550085. If you have those, the first six digits in a dollar bill, then you've got to take part in the contest. Save your dollar bills. The dollar bill contest is going to go on through tomorrow and through next week as well. So you'll have ample opportunity to get a piece of that $30,000 jackpot. Jeff Hewitt, $22,055 in cash and prizes. Still going strong. See you tomorrow on Sale of the Century. Bye-bye.
studio audience and some departing contestants will receive Swanson Clear Chicken Broth. For ads, rich fell, soup, stuffing, gravy, and your favorite hot piece, Swanson Clear Chicken Broth. And clothing by Dobie, the makers of Rainbow Bright. Discover just how bright Mickey with Rainbow Bright Kids Wear by Dobie. Plus Headstrom's Rose Petal Place Sidewalk Bike, a bike blooming with fun and all the quality you expect from Headstrom. And Quality Club Cookware, served up in a hot new color toast. It's Club Balloon's classic seven-piece set. Plus Norelco Clean Air Machine with special four-stage filter system helps remove tobacco smoke, odors, pollen, and dust. From Norelco. Soft soap, liquid soap, now available. Holiday design, soft soap for beauty and softness go hand in hand. All prices are manufacturer's suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. This is Jay George speaking.
The news you can use. It's Barry Morris and Mary Gresham on Action 4 News midday at 11:30. Now adjust your color knob for Vanna White as the Wheel of Fortune rolls your way next on TV4. Let's all be there.
Production.